Hello guys, in this video we will start with the numerical problems which are based on both charging LR and discharging LR circuits. And starting from the first word problem in which we have to find out the values which are given in the question of inductance and resistance, and we have to substitute those values in the equation which we have already formed of current. So many students find it difficult, and I will assure in this video that this should be a very easy process for the students after watching this video. So the factors which are given in the question, we have to write down those factors first. So the resistance is given as 20 ohm, inductance is given as 2 Henry, and the EMF of the cell is given as 4 volts. And we have to find out the current at 0.2 seconds after the connections are made, and also the magnetic field energy. So we know that in the growth, this is a growth LR circuit. Obviously it is not given in the question, and we have analyzed that if the cell is connected in the circuit, then connection of cell signifies that this is a charging LR circuit, because in discharging LR circuit there is no requirement of any cell or battery. So we can easily predict that this is a charging LR circuit. And in charging LR circuit, the equation of growth of current is I is equal to E by R into 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau, where we know that tau is equal to L upon R. Now this is the current. So we are substituting the values as E is equal to 4, R is equal to 20. This is 1 minus e to the power. Now this time constant tau is equal to, this is L by R, and L is 2 and R is 20. So L by R is equal to 0.1. So this is e to the power minus 0.2 upon 0.1, and I will be equal to 1 upon 5, 1 minus e to the power 2 minus 2. So it can be written as I is equal to 1 upon 5 into 1 minus 1 upon e square, and we all know that the value of E is 2.718. So accordingly we can calculate it further. You should always remember that in IIT JEE Advanced, these kind of calculative questions are not asked frequently. In fact, one or two questions are seen every year only, and because they believe in finding out the strength and depth of the concepts, and calculations are the secondary part. So I think these questions are not so important to calculate finally. Now we move on to the next question. In this question, there is a solenoid. Solenoid is obviously an inductor coil whose resistance is 50 ohm and R is given as 50 ohm, and L inductance is given as 80 Henry. The EMF of the cell is 200 volts, and we have to find out the time in which current will attain its half of peak value. So if I naught is its equilibrium final value, then we have to find out the time in which it will attain I naught by 2 value. And also we have to calculate the maximum energy stored. In fact, in the previous question also, we have to calculate the energy stored. So energy stored can be calculated by the formula half Li square. We have already calculated the value of current, and we have been given with the value of inductance, so we can easily calculate this energy stored. Now in this case, I is equal to I naught 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. Again, I have predicted that this is a charging LR circuit because a cell is connected in the circuit. So we have to find out the time when I is equal to I naught by 2. So we have to find out that time. So we are substituting the value of I naught, I, and this is 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. Now the time constant is given as 80 by 50, which is 8 upon 5. And we are cancelling out this. So e to the power minus t upon tau is equal to 1 upon 2. And e to the power t upon tau is equal to 2. So taking log both the sides, so t upon tau is equal to ln 2 and t is equal to tau ln 2. So tau is 8 by 5, so the time is 8 upon 5 ln 2. So in this time, now we know that the value of ln 2 is 2 point, in fact 0.693. So its value can be substituted at this place, and we have to also calculate the maximum energy stored. So the energy, which is equal to half Li square, depends on the current flowing in the circuit. And to maximize this energy, we have to maximize the current flowing. And we know that the maximum current which this circuit attains is I naught. Therefore, U maximum, which can be stored, is half L I naught square, where I naught is equal to E upon R. And by substituting these values, we can also calculate this value of maximum energy stored. Now we move on the next question. In this question, there is a coil of resistance 4 ohm and it is connected across a 0.4 volt battery. Now the current in the coil is 63 milliampere 1 second after the battery is connected. So we have to find out the inductance. Now again, the resistance is given as 4 ohm and the EMF of the cell is given as 0.4 volt. And the current at any instant of time is 63 into 10 raised to power minus 3 ampere. And the time at which this current is given is also 1 second. So we can apply the equation of current as I is equal to I naught, which is equal to E naught E by R, 1 minus E to the power minus T upon tau. Now, in this problem, we have to calculate the self-inductance. And we know that the only term in which self-inductance will come is time constant. So we are calculating the time constant first, and then we will equate that time constant value with L upon R. So the current which is given is 63 into 10 raised to power minus 3. And the EMF of the cell is 0.4 and the resistance is 4. And this is 1 minus e to the power minus t. In fact, the time is given as 1 and this is tau. So this is 63 into 10 raised to power minus 2, because 0.4 upon 4 is 10 raised to power minus 1, and I have cancelled out that. So this is 1 minus e to the power minus 1 upon tau. Now we know that it is 0.63 and it is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus 1 upon tau. So e to the power minus 1 upon tau is equal to 1 minus 0.63, and e to the power minus 1 upon tau is equal to 0.37. So we know that the value of 1 upon e is also equal to 0.37. So e to the power minus, in fact, 1 upon e to the power 1 upon tau is equal to 1 upon e. So by equating these two terms, we can see that 1 upon tau is equal to 1 and tau is equal to 1. Now this tau time constant is equal to L upon R, and therefore L will be equal to R, and R is obviously given as 4, so L is 4 Henry. Now we move on the next question. In this question, the value of inductance, resistance is given, and it is connected to a cell of EMF 2 volts. And we have to find out the di by dt value and L di by dt value at 50 milliseconds. So again, writing the equation of current as I is equal to I naught, 1 minus e to the power minus t upon tau, and differentiating it to find out di by dt. So di by dt will be equal to I naught by tau e to the power minus t by tau. Hopefully you all know the method of differentiation, and this is di by dt. So this I naught is equal to e by r and tau is equal to L by R, and this is e to the power minus t by tau. So di by dt is equal to e by L e to the power minus t by tau, and this will be equal to e is given as 2 and L is given as 1 e to the power minus t, and t is given as 50 milliseconds, so 15 to 10 raised to power minus 3, and R into L is given as 2. So this is di by dt. So di by dt is equal to 2 e to the power minus 25 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Now we have to also find out L di by dt. So we can multiply this di by dt with L. Now we move on the next question. In this question, it is given that we have to find out the current through the battery after the long time in after which switch is closed. And in the second part, we have to suppose that switch is open at t is equal to 0. What will be the time constant of decay circuit and the current through the inductor after one time constant? Now starting with the section A. Section A says that we have to find out the current in the circuit after the long time this switch is closed. So we know that at long time means t is equal to infinity analytically. So at t is equal to infinity, the current in the circuit becomes saturated and there is no voltage drop on the inductor, and therefore we can short circuit the inductor. So after shorting the inductor, I am redrawing the circuit. So this is R2, this is R1, and I have shorted this inductor, and this is cell of EMF E. So we can see that we have to find out the current through the battery after long time. So this is the current, and these two resistances are in parallel, so their equivalent will be equal to R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2, and the current through the cell is equal to E upon R equivalent, and E is given as E, and R equivalent is R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So this is the current which is drawn from the cell. Now for the section B, it is given that suppose that switch is opened at t is equal to 0. So if we will open this switch after keeping it closed for a long time, if we open it, then this cell has no significance in the circuit, and then this circuit would be of discharging LR, and this will be operative circuit, and therefore I am drawing the circuit first. This is R2, this is R1, and this is inductor coil. Okay, so this is the circuit, and current will be flowing through the inductor. Now we have to find out the time constant. So time constant is equal to R L by R equivalent. So in this circuit we can easily see that this R1 and R2 are in series, because current will flow like that. Therefore R1 and R2 would be in series. So equivalent resistance would be equal to R1 plus R2, and hence the time constant will be equal to L upon R1 plus R2. So this is the equivalent time constant. Now we have to also find in the part C that the current in the through the inductor in one time constant. So in this discontinuing from case number B, this is a discharging LR circuit, and in discharging LR circuit the value of current I is equal to I naught into e to the power minus t by tau. Now when the time is equal to one time constant, then I is equal to I naught into e to the power minus 1, and I is equal to I naught by e. Now 1 upon e is 0.37, and the value of I naught was the initial value of I naught when this switch was closed for a long time. So when this switch was closed for a long time, the current which was passing through this inductor branch was I naught. This is very important thing to remember, that in discharging LR circuit we are talking about the inductor, and therefore in the inductor this I naught is that current which was flowing when it inductor attained the saturation state. So in saturation state this is the diagram, and I naught is the current flowing through this inductor branch. We don't need to calculate the total current, we just have to calculate the current flowing through this inductor branch. So if we wish to calculate this current flowing through the inductor branch, we can easily see that these two resistances are parallelly connected to this cell, and hence the potential difference across each one of them R1 and R2 is same, and it is equal to E. So the current flowing through this branch which has R1 connected in it will be E upon R1. So I naught in this case will be equal to E upon R1, and therefore I will be equal to 0.37 into E upon R1. So this is the answer, final answer. Now we move on the next question. In this question, it is given that there is a cell, you can see it has a certain value of 100 volts, and the values of other elements are also given. We have to find out the current I1 and I2 when, in the first case, immediately when this switch is closed. So for solving the first case A, I'm writing it here, I'm drawing the circuit immediately when the switch is closed. So at we are giving this time as a name as t is equal to 0. So at t is equal to 0, when we have just closed this switch, then we know that inductor will offer infinite resistance to the current, and it will not allow the current to flow through it. So the current will not flow through the inductor branch, and hence we can draw the circuit like that the current will only flow from this R2 branch. So the current I2 and I1 will be equal, and I2 will be equal to I1, and it will be equal to E upon R1 plus R2. So E is equal to 100, and R1 plus R2 is equal to 30. So it will be equal to the answer of first part is 10/3 ampere. The value of I1 and I2 are equal. Now after a long time, so for case B, at at t is equal to infinity, we can see that at t is equal to infinity, inductor will get short circuited and the potential difference across the inductor will become zero. So if I draw the circuit diagram at that instant, then it would be like that, that this is R1, this is R2, and inductor will be short circuited. This is R3. So this is the diagram, and total current is I1, and the current flowing through this R2 is I2. So we need to find out both. So the equivalent resistance, first of all, is the parallel combination of R2 and R3. So it is R2 R3 upon R2 plus R3 plus R1, because R1 is in series with them. So the parallel combination of R2 and R3 is 20 into 30 upon 50 plus R1 is 10. So this is equal to 600. In fact, I can write it here. So this is 600 upon 50 plus 10 is equal to R equivalent. So this is 12 plus 10 is 22, and R equivalent will be equal to 22 ohms. Now this current I1 will be equal to E by R equivalent, and E is equal to 100 and upon 22, which is 50 by 11 ampere. And if we need to find out I2, we can see that I2 will be equal to R3 upon R2 plus R3 into I1. This is the current divider rule. I have already explained this current divider rule, and you can find it in my playlist of current and electricity. So R3 is 30 and divided by R2 plus R3 is 50, and into this I1 is 50 by 11. So this would be, I2 would be 30 by 11. Okay. Now for the C part, we have to find out the current I1 and I2 immediately after switch S is opened again. So when this switch is opened again, then I will move on the next page. For the C part, when S is opened, then you can see that there would be no significance of this cell and this resistance in the circuit, because this part is removed by opening the switch, and the only part which is in the circuit is this one. So the only circuit will be this R2, this R3, and this inductor. Okay, so this is the only part, and the current which was flowing through this part was through the inductor, in fact, was this I1 minus I2. So this I1 minus I2 is 50 minus 30 by 11, which is 20 by 11. So the current flowing through this circuit was through this inductor was 20 by 11 ampere. So the first thing which I would like to say, that this current I1 will be zero, because this switch is being opened and I1 would be zero. And in this circuit I2, to find out I2, we can see that I2 is the current flowing through this R2. Okay, so now this R2 is in series with inductor and R3, and this is a very important concept of inductor, that inductor does not allows the sudden changes of current. So the instant at which this switch is opened will have the same current as was in the instant when this switch was just about to open. I mean to say that after closing this switch for a long time, the current which is passing through this inductor is 20 by 11. And the moment I have opened this switch, the inductor will oppose any change of this current, and inductor will keep this current at this value 20 by 11 for that instant after closing the switch. So I2 will be equal to 20 by 11 but in opposite direction, because in the question it is shown that I2 is being flowing in the downward direction, but in this case now the I2 will be flowing in the upward direction from R2, and its value would be 20 by 11. So this is very important concept of inductor, that in any circuit of inductor, if you are just closing or opening the switch, the inductor would keep the current constant for the instant at which the switch is being opened or it is being closed. After some time of being closing or opening the switch, the current will change, but at that same instant current will be same. Now for the D part, in which we have to find out the current after long time, obviously. So after long time, that I1 was 0. Obviously after opening the switch, that I1 was always 0. And after long time, then inductor would be discharged completely, and hence I2 will also become 0. So this is the correct answers of all the cases. Now we move on the next question. In this question, it is given that there are two switches S1 and S2 and two resistance R and 2R connected with the inductor and two cells. Now, it is the situation which is given in the problem is the fact that this switch S2 is initially closed for a long time. So, initially S2 is closed for a long time. So, let's close this switch S2. So this is closed for a long time. Now I am writing it that initially S2 is closed and S1 is kept open for a long time. So initially S2 is kept closed and S1 is kept open for a long time, and in that time the current flowing through the inductor would be the saturation current achieved by this LR circuit. So we know that at infinity, t is equal to infinity, the inductor gets short circuited, which means that the voltage drop against across the inductor becomes zero. So therefore the current which would be flowing through this circuit, this IL, would be due to this cell, and it would be this complete voltage would be appearing on this resistance 2R. Therefore, this current would be E upon 2R. Now, after this long period of time, the switch S1 is also closed. Now, also closed means that switch S2 is not altered and S1 is also closed. Now, S1 is also closed. Now, after closing this switch S1, I am drawing that diagram. This S1 is also closed. Now, you can see that what will be the situation, that this inductor would be connected in parallel with these two cells. One cell is having EMF E and resistance R, and the other cell is having the EMF E and resistance 2R. So this will be the situation. And therefore, if I find out the equivalent of this cell, then the equivalent EMF will be calculated by the formula E1 upon R1, which means E upon R plus E upon 2R upon 1 upon R plus 1 upon 2R. So this will come out to be E. You can see that. And the internal resistance equivalent, R equivalent, will be the parallel combination of R and 2R. So R and 2R combinedly makes 2R by 3. Obviously, we know a fact that inductor does not allows any sudden change of current, and depending on this fact, we can say that still at the time when this switch is closed, when S1 is closed, still the current flowing through the inductor would be IL, because it will not tolerate any change in its current, and this current will last only for few instant of time, and after the time passes, this current would change. Now again, we can see that we have to find out this di by dt across the inductor, and we have to find out the potential difference across this resistance R. So now I can connect this inductor with a battery which is having a EMF of E, and the internal resistance is 2R by 3 and EMF is E. Okay, so the current which would be flowing in this circuit at this instant of time when S1 is just closed would be IL, and this IL would be flowing from 2R by 3 also. Now let's suppose that the voltage across 2R by 3 is V1. So V1 would be equal to IR, and hence IL will be E by 2R, and this is 2R by 3. So V1 would be equal to E by 3. This is the voltage across this resistance 2R by 3. Now the remaining voltage would be appearing on this inductor VL. So VL would be total voltage E minus E by 3, which is appearing on the resistance. So it is 2 E by 3, which is the voltage which appears on this inductor. So we know that the EMF or voltage across the inductor E is L di by dt, and it is equal to 2 E by 3, and therefore di by dt would be equal to 2 E by 3L. Now what about the sign of di by dt? Now I am demonstrating it in other page, that when we have to find out the sign of di by dt, so we know very simply that if this EMF, if this current is increasing, then di by dt is positive, and if this current is decreasing, then di by dt is negative. Now the initial current which was flowing after closing that switch S2, it was IL, and it was E by 2R. You can see here IL was E by 2R. Now after long time of closing this switch S1, okay, so after long time when this circuit is completed and both the switches are closed, then after long time at t is equal to infinity, the saturation current I0 in the circuit would be equal to E by 2R by 3. So you can see that the initial current which was flowing in this circuit was IL, and it was E by 2R, and this final current is E by 3 E by 2R. So we can say that this IL is less than I0. And if the initial current is less than the final current, then we can say this is the initial one and this is the final one. So if the initial current is less than the final current, then we can say that the current is increasing. Therefore, current is increasing. And if the current is increasing, then di by dt would be positive and its value was 2e by 3l, which I have already calculated here. So this is the di by dt with positive sign. And now we have to find out the potential difference across R. Now we have already written that the potential difference across this 2R by 3 is V1, which is E by 3. Now this 2R by 3 is made up of the combination, parallel combination of R and 2R. So obviously this voltage which is appearing across this 2R by 3, this is V1, would be the voltage across both of these resistances R and 2R, and hence we can say that the voltage across R would be equal to V1, and V1 was E by 3, which we have already calculated that it is E by 3. So the two answers are following, which is the voltage across R is E by 3 and di by dt is plus 2E by 3L. Now we move on the next question. In this question, it is given that initial current in an LR circuit was 20 ampere and after 2 seconds it reduces to 18 ampere. Now we have to find out the time constant. This is clear that if current is reducing, then this is a discharging LR circuit, and to find out the time constant of discharging LR circuit, we have to use the equation of current, which says that I is equal to I naught e to the power minus t upon tau. So this is the equation for discharging of LR circuit, and the current which is given at 2 seconds is 18 ampere, so this would be 18 ampere, and the initial current was 20 ampere, so I naught is equal to 20 ampere, and the time which is given is 2 seconds, yeah, and it is 2 and upon tau. Tau is the time constant. So this is 9 by 10 and it is equal to e to the power minus 2 by tau, and e to the power 2 by tau is equal to 10 by 9. Taking log both the sides, 2 upon tau is equal to ln 10 upon 9, and hence this tau will be equal to 2 upon ln 10 upon 9. So the correct option would be option number C. Now moving on to the next question. In this question, we have to find out the ratio of I1 and I2, where I1 is the initial current in the circuit drawn from the battery and I2 is the steady state current drawn through the battery. Now what does this initial word means here? That it is the time just after closing the switch, and therefore we know that at at t is equal to 0, S is closed, this is switch S, and it is just being closed at t is equal to 0. So at this instant we know that inductor will offer infinite resistance and it will not allow the current to pass through it. So the circuit would be seen like that there would be no current through the inductor branch, and this branch will not be drawn in the circuit because it has no significance as no current is flowing through it. So this is the only circuit which is at t is equal to 0. And the current which is flowing in this circuit from the battery I1 will be equal to 10 by 10, which is I1 is equal to 1 ampere. Now at t is equal to infinity, we know that inductor gets short circuited and the voltage across this inductor becomes 0. So if I draw the circuit, I am short circuiting this inductor. This is the circuit. So in this circuit you can see that the current flowing through the cell I2 has to be calculated. So we know that this 4 and 4 will be 2 ohm because they are connected in parallel, and 6 and 2 are connected in series. So equivalent resistance would be equal to 8 ohms and the current I2 would be equal to 10 upon 8, and I2 would be equal to, this is 5 by 4. Now we need to find out I1 upon I2. So I1 upon I2 will be 4 by 5. And therefore, the correct option would be option number D, 0.8. Now, moving on to the next question. In this question, a cell, a resistance R and an inductor are connected all in parallel to each other. And initially, the current in the inductor was 0. Now, the current through this battery we have to calculate at t is equal to 2 seconds. Now, you should see this problem very carefully, that it is not a LR circuit. It is not a transient LR circuit in which we have used that equation of current I is equal to I naught e to the power minus t by tau. This is not that circuit. In this circuit, this is a simple circuit in which there are two elements which are connected in parallel to each other and to the battery, and therefore the EMF of the battery would be seen on both of these elements constantly. So this EMF E would be the voltage of these two elements throughout the time, and hence this is not a charging or discharging LR circuit. So we can just say that the current through this resistance is, let's suppose, I1, and I1 will always be constant because this resistance has a constant potential difference E across it. So the value of I1 would be equal to I'm writing it here, that I1 will be always constant, and value of I1 would be equal to E by R. So the value of E is 10 and R is 5, so it is 2 ampere. The value of I1 is 2 ampere. Now we have to find out the value of I2, which is at 2 seconds. We have to find out this I2, which means that the current through this inductor is variable due to the fact that the potential difference across inductor E is also the EMF, and it is equal to L di by dt. Now E is equal to 10 volts, and 10 is equal to L is 2 and di by dt. So di is equal to 5 dt. Integrating both the sides, I is equal to 5 t, and at 2 seconds I is equal to 10. So the total current, in fact this is I2, so the total current would be equal to, I would be equal to I1 plus I2. So I is equal to 12 amperes. So the correct answer is 12 amperes. Now moving on to the next question. In this question, it is given that this is a circuit containing inductor, and we have to find out the energy stored in this inductor when the EMF of this inductor is 50% of its peak value. Now we know that this is a circuit in which I'm redrawing the circuit. This is 1 ohm and this is the inductor 5 millihenry, and this one is 2 ohm and this battery has a voltage of 2 volts. So you can see that these are two separate circuits. This resistance is having a constant voltage of 2 volts and therefore a constant current of 1 ampere would flow from this resistance, and this is a LR charging circuit having a voltage of 2 volts. So we are concerned with this one only. So we know that the maximum voltage of this inductor V not L, this is the maximum voltage across the inductor, and it is always initially at the situation at the time when the switch is just being closed. So initially this inductor has infinite resistance and it will not allow the current to flow through this branch, and hence this complete voltage of 2 volt will appear at the terminals of inductor. So the maximum voltage appearing across the inductor would be 2 volts. This is the maximum voltage, and we know that the transient equation for the voltage across the inductor is VL equal to V naught L, which is the maximum voltage across the inductor, into 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. This is the maximum voltage. In fact, this equation would have direct e to the power minus t by tau, because it is a decaying function of time. This voltage is decreasing with time because we know that initially the voltage across the inductor is maximum, and that as time will progress the voltage across this inductor would be zero at infinite time. So this is a decay equation, and hence this would be like that. Now we know that we have to substitute the value of VL as 50% of V naught L. So it is V naught L by 2. So this is V naught L by 2 is equal to V naught L e to the power minus t by tau. This is cancelled out, and e to the power t by tau is equal to 2. So t by tau is equal to ln 2, and t is equal to tau ln 2. Now we don't have to find out this time. In fact, we have to find out the energy stored in the inductor at this instant. So the energy stored in the inductor is equal to half Li square, and equation of current is equal to, this is I naught 1 minus e to the power minus t by tau. So this I is equal to I naught, where I naught is the maximum current which will be flowing through this inductor, and it is equal to E upon R. Now the resistance should be the resistance which is a part of this LR circuit. So the resistance which is the part of this LR circuit is only 1 ohm. This 2 ohm is having some separate current through it, and it has no role to play in this LR circuit. So the value of I naught will be E upon R, and E is 2 ohm, 2 volts, and R is 1 ohm. So this is 1 minus E to the power. Now the time is tau ln 2, and if I substitute the value of this time in this equation, then this tau will be cancelled out. This is minus ln 2. So I is equal to 2, 1 minus 1 upon e to the power ln 2. Now we know that e to the power ln 2 will be 2. So this current would be equal to 2 into 1 minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 1 ampere. So current I will be equal to 1 ampere, and the energy will be equal to half L I square. L is 5 millihenry and current is 1. So the correct option for the energy would be 2.5 millijoules. Now we move on the next question. In this question, it is given that this switch S is connected to this position 2 for a long time, and then it is shifted to position 1, and then we have to find out the heat produced in this resistance R1. So first of all, we have to find out the total energy stored in the inductor when switch is connected to position 2. So when when switch S is connected to position 2, then the maximum current which would be flowing through this inductor would be E upon R, and R is R2. So I naught is E upon R2, and the energy stored in this inductor would be half L I naught square. So this energy would be half L, and I naught has a value E square upon R2 square. So this is the value of energy which is stored in this inductor. Now we have to find out the heat produced across this resistance R1. So when we have connected this resistance R1 alone with this inductor L, then we know that the heat produced will be equal to the energy stored in the inductor, and hence the heat produced can be written as half L E square by R2 square. So this would be the value of heat produced across this resistance R1. So the correct option would be option number A. Now moving on the next question.